unexpected change remains. Unexpected news remains. Seasons of life that are overwhelming persist. They always reside. Injustice exists. Suffering persists. Death and violence continues. Simply look at our world. The images, the testimonials, the stories from medical professionals in Palestine. Take evidence, seeing the videos of innocent Palestinian children, teens, women, elderly people deliberately killed in this day by the hunting of Hamas terrorists. It has been overwhelming. Saddening, horrific, unsettling. It is genocide. This is the very definition of genocide, to intentionally destroy a people in whole or in part with the intent to demolish the national, ethnical, racial, or religious. I can only imagine how many children, how many mothers, how many fathers have cried out, Kurios, Soso, Men, rescue me, Lord. I wonder, is the U.S. government listening and watching? Is our president paying attention? See, because what I see here is the same point that Dr. King made in a speech titled Beyond Vietnam, A Time to Break Silence, that he delivered in April 4, 1967. Exactly 1 year before he was assassinated, he asserted that our nation needed to go a radical shift. To rapidly begin to shift from a thing-oriented society to a person-oriented society. And here we are, 60 years later, and our country's values continue to place things above it. And listen, I'm well aware of the United States' national interests, security reasons, and presence in the Middle East. Aware of the intelligence we acquired from Israel, well aware of the historical affinity that the U.S. has with Israel. Similar values, similar government, an extreme robust collaborative military system. How can we forget all the religious reasons that a Christian nation would support a Jewish state? I'm even aware of all the major financial and business reasons for supporting Israel. My question is, where's the human? Where is the value for human life? Because I do not see it. Instead, what I see is an America that is more consumed with their things, their own interests, their own politics, their own money, that is more than rescuing of innocent people. Or at least, how about we just protect the children? Doctors Without Borders, you know this organization, this charity work, humanitarian efforts, medical care, recently said that children as young as 5 years old in Gaza have told them they wanted more. 5 years old saying such things. UNICEF, the UN Agency for the Protection of Children, estimates that 17,000 children in the Gaza Strip are either unaccompanied or have been separated from their immediate relatives since the beginning of the war in Gaza. And of the 30,000 Palestinians killed, more than 12,400 have been killed. It's nearly half. At what point is the U.S. no longer complicit, participatory in the intentional destruction? See, despite the intentional sinking of these people, when one hears from Palestinian parents is a resilience of faith, shall we say. The conviction of things not seen. They keep fighting for hope, for salvation, for survival. And when one hears in the background our kids playing and laughing, trying to enjoy their childhood to the best of their ability for as long as they can. And in spite of all that pain, regardless of all the suffering and injustice, all the uncertainty, still Palestinian families have faith that one day they shall return to their normal lives again, to live in peace again, to have children go to school again, to work and make a living with the basic needs and rights that all humans deserve. This might be a way of stepping out of the boat into the darkness, into the uncertainty, trusting that the divine will be there when they cry out, God, rescue me, God, save me, Kuria Sosome. The Creator, three in one, is present with the poor, present with the underbelly of the world, with the displaced, with the hurting, the hungry, and the suffering. With a population of nearly 5 million people in Gaza and in the West Bank, there are still many surviving. Here's what I'll say to all those in the midst of war and suffering, to those who are in the midst of spiritual bewilderment, to those who are stepping out of the boat day after day after day, to those who are walking by faith and not by sight, I say to you, be encouraged. Do not fear. Be bold in your human living. Continue to move fearlessly through this earthly life, because you are inherently loved. You are foundation of the earthly creatures coming from the earth and returning to the soil, forever marked with the earthliness of the cross of Jesus. This is your origin story, made from dust and in the image of the divine. Remember, the divine is with you. So boldly step out into the unknown. There, God will meet you. And when you cry out, when you cry for help, when you cry to be saved, when you cry to be rescued, because that moment will come. Trust. Trust that the divine will be close enough.